next to the speaker. Now that is a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be a creature they call the gazette, or sort of a kind of a hat-wearing
cat!
I can see you've got quite a mind for your age.
Why, one thing, and you dragged me right onto the stage!
Well, here, there's no telling what may assume.
With a cat such as me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think, oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or cake with a stink, or a stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up together. Oh, the things you can think, when you think about
this!
Up in a tree.
Think of a person too sunny to see.
Think of a bird with the one feather tail.
Going on adventure down a dangerous trail. Ah!
Think of a bird who flies off on a spree.
Think of a kangaroo as sour as can be.
Think of a monkey with trouble in store.
Think of something horrible and hairy, something tender and scary that you never dared to think of before. Think of nobody here, and the feeling of fear, and the darkness of night. Ooh. All alone in your room, as you're facing your doom,
think a glimmer of light.
Ah! And
I hope we're prepared
to be scared than scared, cause it's a mother goose.
It is right on the brain.
What do you think about? What do you think about food? What do you think about food?
Will soon be unfurled.
Of an elephant trying to save a small world.
Our story begins with the very same sound.
The drums of the jungle begin to pound.
Now think of an elephant lumbering through.
Horton? Yes, Horton, here's a who.
And the cool of the pool.
He was splashing.
Splash!
Enjoying the jungle's great joys.
When Horn the elephant heard a small noise.
Help! Help! Look, a small speck of dust blowing past through the air. I say, how confusing. I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that is able to yell. So you know what I think? I think that there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. He's alone in the universe.
Just have to save him, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
So gently and using the greatest of care,
the elephant stretched her great trunk through the air.
She lifted the dust speck and carried it over
and placed it down safely on a very soft clover.
in her pouch, said,
Huh, too.
Why, that speck is as small as the head of a pin. Why, a person on that weather has never been.
Huh.
Through the jungle, the news quickly flew. She talks to a dust speck.
It's on channel 2.
Oh, God.
Our topic today is a psychic elephant who hears voices. What do you think, folks? Is the elephant off her trunk?
My name is Gertrude McFuzz, and I live right next door. Horn has never done anything crazy before. She has always been friendly, loyal, and kind. I just don't believe Horn's out of her mind.
I'm Maisie LaBert. I live in that tree. Enough about Horn. Let's talk about me.
I'll just have to save him because, after all, a person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how.
Seen her voice calling over and over.
Help!
So he tried to think, who might be down on that slope?
An invisible world, amazing but true, and now guess who enters the story?
Who?
You!
Hello? Is anyone there? Who are you?
Well, we're who's here. We are who's here. Smaller than the eye can see. It's who, sir. We're who.
Jojo, I'm the mayor of Pooh. Well, I've just been elected, and upper behavior is thus forth expected.
We just had a talk with your teacher today. They didn't have one single good thing to say.
Your things were so wild, they disrupted your classes.
And you made Miss McAhoo drop new glasses.
Now, Horton has found us. We're safe on a clover. But clearly, our troubles are far, far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you. Oh, yes, dear. But could you try thinking just a bit less, dear?
You got me in trouble. Get out. Go away.
All right. We'll be going. But first, let us say, oh, the things you can think.
Stop!
Oh, the things you can think.
Be quiet!
Watching you splish.
I'm not listening.
As you stay
la,
here
la,
in front,
la,
have
la,
a
la,
think
la,
in
la,
the
la,
tub. Think of water and fish.
Fish?
Think of pipes in the floor, leading off to the shore, where the water is cool.
Junior Tub's not a tub.
It's my delicate pool.
Read in the books, connected to one of those underground brooks, an underground river that starts here and flows right under the bathtub, and then who knows?
It's possible. Anything's possible.
Overflowed onto the floor. The water is running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling. You flooded in. Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again.
I say this with firmness and terrible sorrow. Young lady, come. We will deal with you tomorrow.
I've been guarding this clover for over a week, getting laughed at for thinking a dust speck can speak. Well, let them laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something that they'll never find.
Stand on my own, so be it.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
It's me, Jojo, the mayor's daughter.
I'm Horton, the elephant.
Are you real, or are you just a very large thing?
Oh, I'm real, all right. I would state that in ink.
In my thing, I imagine a lot of strange things, and I go to strange places as if I had wings. I love a good thing.
Well, for me, that goes double.
Sometimes my things would get me in trouble.
When you think, do you dream?
And bright colors.
Me too. And I go to strange places, like Sala Salu.
What do you think? Do you think you can fly to the stars?
Little friend, no one else could have things such as ours.
Song for Horton, number 437.
But she sang a nice song.
Kids, fasten your seatbelt, 'cause now things go wrong.
Business, that's what we intend to do. Come on, I want a monkey, monkey around.
on the 302. I'd funnel toward your route if I were you.
That clover drop somewhere inside of a big patch of clovers, 100 miles wide. I'll find it or bust. I must find my friends on their small speck of dust. Who's there?
It's me, Maisie, up here.
Maisie, are you on a nest?
Yeah, you want to make something of it?
No, just never thought I'd see you on a nest, that's all.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I. Hey, Horton, would you maybe like to sit on my nest?
Oh, Maisie, I couldn't. Of all silly things, I haven't got feathers and I haven't got wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a search. I just couldn't leave my poor hoos in their lurch.
I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back, because I'm that sort of bird.
Well, we all need vacations. All right, go on, take it. I'll sit on your egg, and I'll try not to break it. But hurry back quick. 1 hour, maybe two. I've got to find JoJo. I've got to save who. For 51 weeks.
I may be unreliable, fancy, free, irresponsible, crazy me, but seeing you gives me true delight. Just for once, I've done something right. The egg is yours. No, don't thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck and goodbye.
No, I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful, 100%. I'll protect you from harm. I'll do it or die. Now rest, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby.
whatever she deserves.
Horton, Horton, are you there?
What? Who is it?
It's me, Gertrude. Horton, oh, Horton, there's nothing that I couldn't, wouldn't, and haven't gone through. And it took me 7 weeks, but I found your clover.
Oh, Gertrude, thank you. You're amazing.
Well, it was nothing.
Hello? Who's? Hello? Is anyone there? Hello? Oh, Mr. Mayor, what a relief. Is JoJo around?
Hi, Horton.
Oh, kid, now that I've got you, I won't let you go and I won't let you fall. Because after all,
a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how.
Ha! Ha!
Ha!
How'd you get here?
Hey, stop! Where are you taking me?
Horton, we're taking you back.
You're gonna be in style. For talking to us back and sitting on an egg.
You're gonna be put on trial.
This is the case of the people versus Horton the elephant. Judge Hurdle the turtle presiding. The defendant is charged with talking to a speck, disturbing the peace, and loitering on an egg.
Your Honor, this clover is Exhibit A. There are who's here smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. He's a who, and so is she. You, Mr. Mayor, oh, please, Mr. Mayor, you've got to prove you really are there.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendants Horton the Elephant remanded in no asylum for the criminally insane. And as for the deathbed, it will boil in a hot, steaming kettle of bismuth oil.
Jojo, think of something!
But then,
then came a thing of a peculiar word, the kind of word no one has ever heard.
Yeah! Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They've made themselves heard, although they can't be seen.
They prove they are persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
How true, yes, how true, to the sour kangaroo. And from now on, you know what I'm planning to do? From now on, I'm going to protect them with you.
Whatsoever be heard.
When your things have run dry.